Good morning, children. In your previous class, you have studied about that how is sound produced by a vibrating body. We also discussed about the activities. See, children, the sound and the vibrations, they are linked to each other. See, when the vibrations are produced, then the sound is produced. When there is no vibration, then the sound will not be produced. See, vibration means it is the to and forth or back and forth motion of an object. It is called as the vibration. See, children, any vibrating object, it produces the sound. In some cases, the vibrations are easily visible to us, but in most cases, their amplitude is so small that we cannot see them. So the vibrations and the sound, they are both linked to each other. In today's class, we will study about the how is sound produced by the humans. How is sound produced by the humans? See, children, when you speak loudly for a while or sing a song or buzz like a bee, put your hand on your throat as shown in the figure here. See, children, whenever you speak loudly or while you sing a song, see, you put your hand on the throat as shown in the figure here. And observe that here, do you feel any vibrations here? In humans, the sound is produced by the voice box. See, children, in humans, the sound is produced by the voice box or the larynx. Put your fingers on the throat here and find a hard bump that seems to move when you swallow. See, children, you do it and see, whenever you swallow something, you put your hand on your put your fingers on the throat or put your fingers on the throat and you find a hard bump here that seems to move when you swallow. This part of the body, it is known as the voice box. This is known as the voice box. It is at the upper end of the windpipe. See, children, it is at the upper end of the windpipe. Two vocal cords are stretched across the voice box. See, children, here, two vocal cords, these are stretched across the voice box or a larynx in such a way that it leaves a narrow slit between them for passing of air. See here, children, this is the narrow slit. It has been shown here, children. It is a narrow slit here. These are the two vocal cords. These are stretched across the voice box or a, it is called as the larynx in such a way that it leaves a narrow slit between the between them for the passage of air, to allow the air to pass through it. Here there is a narrow slit. This is the voice box in humans. And when the lungs force the air through the slit, see, children, when the lungs force the air through the slit, the vocal cords vibrate. See, children, when the lungs, they force the air through the slit here, the vocal cords, they vibrate, producing the sound. The muscles attached to the vocal cords, they can make the cords tight or loose. The muscles which are attached to the vocal cord, they can make the cords tight or loose. And when the vocal cords are tight and thin, the type or quality of voice is different from that when they are loose and thick. See, children, here, when the vocal cord, they are tight and they are thin, the type or the quality of voice is different from that when they are loose and thick. Now let us see how the vocal cords function. See here, children, another one activity is there here. You take two rubber strips of same size. These are the rubber strips of two of the same size. Place these two pieces one above the other and stretch them tight. See, children, you have to place them one above the other and stretch them tightly. And now blow the air through the gap between them. You have to blow the air. There will be some gap here. You blow the air through the gap between them. Now, as the air blows through the stretched rubber strips, a sound is produced here. See children here. As the air is blown through the stretched rubber strips, a sound is produced. You can try this in your home. You have to take two rubber strips of the same size and stretch them tightly and blow the air through the gap between them. When you blow the air, there will be a sound produced. And you can also take a piece of a paper. See children, it has been shown in figure 8.9b. You can also take a piece of a paper with a narrow slit. This is a narrow slit. Take a piece of paper with a narrow slit and hold it between your fingers like this. You have to hold it between your fingers. Now blow through the slit. Blow the air through the slit and you listen to the sound here. You have to blow the air through the narrow slit here and you listen to the sound. Our vocal cords, they produce the sound in a similar manner. See children, whenever you blow the air through the narrow slit of a piece of a paper, it produces a sound here. Our vocal cords produces the sound in a similar manner as it produced here previously. The vocal cords in men, see children, the vocal cords in men are about 20 millimeter long. In women, these are about 15 millimeter long. And in children, have a very short vocal cords. See children, the vocal cords of men, women and children are different here. For men, it is 20 millimeter long. For women, it will be 15 millimeter long. And for children, they have a very short vocal cords. This is the reason, children, why the voices of men, women are children. They are different. Now, let us discuss about how a sound needs a medium for propagation. Means a sound needs a medium to travel. When you call up your friend children who is standing at a distance, your friend is able to hear your voice. How does the sound propagate or travel to her? Now, let us see that. Here, there is one activity. You have to take a metal or a glass tumbler. See children, you have to take a metal tumbler or a glass tumbler. Now, make sure that it is dry. It should be not wet. Make sure that it is dry. Place a cell phone in it. Remember that the cell phone must not be kept in a water. Don't pour water in these children. You make sure that the tumbler is dry and put a cell phone in that. Ask your friend to give a ring on this cell. Ask your friend to give a ring on this phone from another cell phone. Now listen to the ring carefully. Listen to the ringing sound carefully. Now surround the rim of the tumbler like this, children. You have to surround the rim of the tumbler with your hands. Now put your mouth on the opening mouth of the tumbler with your hands. See children here. Put your mouth on the opening between your hands here like this. Put your mouth on the opening between your hands here like this. Indicate to your friend to give a ring again. See children, you tell your friend to give a ring again now. Now listen to the ringing sound of the phone while sucking the air from the tumbler. See children, you again listen to the ringing sound of the cell phone while sucking the air from the tumbler now. Now you observe that, does the sound become fainter as you suck the air? See children, you observe that. Does the sound become fainter as you suck the air? Now, remove the tumbler from your mouth. Now, remove this tumbler from your mouth. Does the sound become loud again? See children, when you remove the tumbler from your mouth, does this sound become loud again? See? Now, can you think of an explanation here, children? See children, when you see, when you suck the air here from the tumbler, obviously the sound decreases now. The sound decreases when you suck the air from the tumbler. See, when you didn't suck the air from the tumbler, then when you didn't suck the air from the tumbler here, then the sound was more now previously. Now, when you suck the air from the tumbler, then the sound became less.
See, children, when the air is, when you suck the air from the tumbler, then the sound decreases. The sound decreases, children, here. Now, is it possible that the decreasing amount of air in the tumbler had something to do with the decreasing loudness of the ringing sound of the cell phone? Indeed, children, if you had been able to suck all the air in the tumbler, you will not listen any sound here. See, children, if you had been able to suck all the air in the tumbler, then you will not listen to any kind of a sound. Actually, from this activity, we will find out that here the sound needs a medium to travel here. Now, when the air has been removed completely from a vessel, it is said that there is a vacuum in the vessel. We say that there is a vacuum in the vessel. See, when the air has been removed completely from a vessel, now the vessel will be empty. It will not contain any air now. It is said that there is a vacuum in the vessel. The sound cannot travel through a vacuum. Understood, children? The sound cannot travel through a vacuum. It needs a medium to travel now. That is, see, you observe that first, when the cell phone was put in the tumbler, when your friend made a ring to your cell phone, you hear the sound clearly. You heard the sound loudly of a ringing sound of a cell phone. Now, when you completely suck the air from the tumbler, then you didn't hear any sound now. Means the sound needs the medium to travel. From this activity, we can understand, children, here. See, till now we discussed that how the sound is produced by the humans, and also sound needs a medium to propagate. Still some more activities are there. We will discuss them in our next class, children. You read these all, whichever I discussed till now. Thank you, children.